ओम योगेन चित्तस्य पदेन वाचा मलम शरीरस्य च वैद्यकेन योपाकरोत्तम प्रवरम मुनीनां पतंजलिम प्राञ्जलिरानतोऽस्मि। मंडे लास्ट मंडे वी रेड अप टू 35 sutras and in between, in the 32 sutras, there was a reference to Kurma Nadi, and I wondered and many people wondered somebody is wrongly gone to presenting. That where is this Kurma Nadi? Now, I tried in the internet and I got one answer. That this Kurma Nadi is on the upper part of the chest below the throat. Upper part of the chest below the throat. That is the position of Kurma Nadi. More than this, I could not get any information in any commentators. So, this is for your information. Now, we were seeing various powers and that the powers are digressive at the least, dangerous at the most, and so Patanjali is mentioning them so that accidentally, we should not feel tempted by them, we should not succumb to them, and then only we should go to the goal. Some of the powers may be such that they may be useful for our spiritual life, we may use them. So now we proceed to Sutra 36. Sattva Purusha Yoho अत्यंत असंकीर्णयो हो प्रत्यय अविशेषात् भोगः परार्थत्वात् स्वार्थ संयमात् पुरुष ज्ञानम्। नाउ दिस इज नॉट एन ऑर्डिनरी पावर, वी आर गोइंग टू गेट टू नो द पुरुष बाय दिस पर्टिकुलर संयम। नाउ Sattva means buddhi. Here sattva is not sattva guna. Sattva guna means our buddhi. Purusha. Purusha is our real nature, consciousness. Atyanta asankirnayo. They are not at all connected. They are totally different from each other. Pratyaya avisheshat. But in our perception, they are not separate. They are not different. Our buddhi, rather, I repeat, our eye consciousness and our real consciousness. Real consciousness from Vedanti point of view, it is only God. But Sankhya and Yoga point of view, it is pure consciousness. It has no element of I there. Now this pure consciousness reflects in the buddhi and we feel I do this, I do that. So though buddhi and pure consciousness are entirely separate, in our perception they are not so. Guru Pratyaya means perception, avishesha, not perception, our consciousness, our bodha today, that is our knowledge today, which is ajnana. He has already defined ajnana. So, our actual bodha today. So, we are reading Sutra. Sattva Purusha Yoho Atyanta Asankirna Yoho Pratyaya Avisheshat Svarthatvat Svartha Sanyamat Purusha Jnanam. Now, one central word here, there are two sentences here. In the first sentence, the central word is bhoga. Why is this life of experiencing prakriti? Because sattva means buddhi, purusha means our consciousness real. Though they are absolutely separate, unmixed with each other, atyanta asankirnayo, totally disparate. Yet, pratyaya, in our consciousness, in our actual experience, avisheshat, they are not distinguished. That means this I consciousness, that itself we feel is our real nature. That is called they are not separated. And then bhoga, that leads us to enjoying or experiencing the objective world. The reason for experiencing objective world is that our real consciousness gets mixed up with I consciousness. Buddhi is nothing but our I consciousness. So it gets mixed up with buddhi, and then we perceive the outside world, and then we are enjoying or experiencing the outer world. Pararthatvat. Pararthatvat means buddhi. Buddhi is a part of the combination. And whatever is part of a combination is usually for somebody else. That is a Sankhya Sutra, Sanghataha Pararthatvat. If there is a combination, it is working for somebody else. Sometimes we say, this chair and table are made for each other. Sometime back, if you remember, even the tobacco and filter made for each other in the cigarette. Now, chair is not made for table. Table is not made for chair. Chair and table are made for a man to sit on the chair and read on the table. So it is for a third person. Wherever there is a combination, it is for a third person. So this buddhi being a part of the combination, or even this, our confusion with buddhi becomes a combination, and this is for somebody else. Who for somebody else? I, the experiencer. I, the experiencer of the objective world. I, the enjoyer of the objective world. Because I get mixed up with my buddhi, and this mixture is the cause for experiencing the external objects. Svartha Sanyamat. Now, Svartha means not selfishness. Swartha means self-centeredness. One who is for himself. Who is for himself? Purusha. Buddhi is not for herself, but Purusha is for himself. Now, if you can we are able to separate them. Due to penetrative consciousness, we are able to separate. This is Purusha and this is Buddhi. So if you concentrate on Swartha, that means on Purusha, the self-centeredness of the Purusha, then Purusha Jnanam, we clearly become aware of the Purusha. So this is almost reaching the goal of Patanjali Yoga, though it is not the goal, but we are able to clearly perceive Purusha as different from Buddhi. That is the goal. We are clearly able to perceive consciousness pure, different from self-consciousness or mixed up consciousness with my buddhi. That is the sutra. So in between discussing powers, a powerful weapon has been given to us. Instead of doing sanyama here and there, why not penetratively concentrate on your real nature? Why not concentrate on this fact that you are separate from buddhi? Patanjali Yoga is not going to lead us further than this, mind you. Patanjali Yoga will be ending in our separateness from prakriti. If Yogatmanda is there, he had asked a question. Ajnana in Patanjali is not what you think as Ajnana. Ajnana in Patanjali is only mixing up body with the self. So, the separation between the self and buddhi comes here when we are able to concentrate on their separateness or concentrate on being ourselves. Concentrate not on ourselves or prakriti for purusha. We are concentrate on what we are. We are concentrate on what we are for. We are not for enjoying prakriti, but we are for establishing our real self. This comes by this penetrative consciousness. And this leads to, you remember in a previous sutra, just previous, 34, Pratibhadva Sarvam was given. And that day I told that this Pratibha comes from purity of mind, absolute purity of the mind. Now Patanjali himself is telling how the Pratibha comes. If you are able to separately feel Purusha than Buddhi, this leads to Pratibha. Tataha means from that. Pratibha, Shravana, Vedana, Darsha, Swada, Varta, Jayante. What is this Pratibha, Shravana, Vedana, Darshana, Swada, Varta? That means something like television. Something is happening at a distance, we are able to see it. Something is happening at a distance, we are able to hear that. Something is happening at a distance, we are able to smell that. Something is happening outside, we are able to taste that. So, supernatural perception. Here he says Pratibha. Due to the Pratibha Jnan, we are able to have super sensuous perception. Now, this relates us with an example in Swamiji Vivekananda's life. Swamiji was not practicing this type of yoga. He was practicing normal meditation. But during that, suddenly, this power came into him. And because of his scientific mind, scientific means outside science, he doubted his perception. And he went to that place which he was seeing. And he saw, yes, they are there, they are talking like this, which I heard. Now, this used to happen again and again. And that started disturbing his meditation. So he asked Sri Ramakrishna what to do. Such thing is happening. Now, this boy or young man, whom Sri Ramakrishna said, Dhyan Siddha, he has come to this world along with his capacity to meditate. So natural meditation was for him. Sri Ramakrishna told him, don't meditate for some days. Don't meditate. Inside you can practice Viveka. And I do not want this type of power. I want God. And when you gain control, then start meditation again. This was his advice. So here, due to feeling of separation between Purusha and Prakriti, Purusha and Buddhi, this type of super perception comes. You remember, in the beginning I told you about Alaukika Pratyaksha. This is that Alaukika Pratyaksha. This is one type of Alaukika Pratyaksha. Because Alaukika Pratyaksha is seeing God in Bhava. That is Alaukika Pratyaksha. But this is also super sensuous perception. Our indriyas are not coming directly in contact with that object. It is at a distance. But we are able to see that. We are able to hear that. We are able to touch it. We are able to smell it. We are able to taste it. So it becomes included in vibhutis only. Though 36 sutra appeared to give us knowledge of Purusha, it has not given us full knowledge of Purusha. It has only suggested to us that Purusha is different from buddhi. And this has, that means up till now we have thought Purusha is different from buddhi. But now we have come to a sort of perceptive knowledge that Purusha is separate from buddhi. And that has given us special pratibhadnan, special knowledge. And the special knowledge, Pratibhadva Sarvam, all the powers come by Pratibha. So one of the powers coming by Pratibha is that super sensuous perception. So from this reflecting on Sutra 36, we understand that this is not the real separation which we wanted. So we revise our meaning of that. The combination is working for something different. We are trying to pick up the element which is for itself, that is Swartha Sanyama. We are trying to concentrate not on objects of the world, not of our perception of the objects of the world, but we are able to concentrate on our own nature, that much. We are not seeing our real nature. We are revising our translation now because Sutra 37, we have to reflect on 36. And that has generated a super sensuous perception. There is a feeling. You may put it as a feeling. We are able to feel that Purusha is different from Prakriti. We have not seen it. So, this concentration on the element, what is for itself, Purusha is for himself. Prakriti is for Purusha, but Purusha is not for Prakriti, Purusha is for himself. This much feeling has arisen in us. And that is why he has not given it as a vibhuti also, a feeling. And that feeling gives us super sensuous perception. Now he gives that famous sutra which I have been telling you. Te means up till now whatever powers have been discussed. Up to Sutra 37. Samadho Upasarga. They are obstructions or troubles for our full concentration. Here samadhi means full, total concentration, the end of samprajnata, from where we will jump into vritti nirodha. So, for samadhi, they are the obstructions. Because we become tempted, we saw how Swamiji became disturbed. Swamiji became disturbed and he controlled it. But we become tempted because of so many powers. And the powers are very destructive, I told you. So, Patanjali here is telling us, Vyutthane Siddhaya. Now the word Vyutthane is different in Patanjali and Vedanta, let me remind you. Patanjali in the very beginning has told us, when there is Vritti Nirodh, then Drashta Surupe Avasthana. In all other states, Vritti Sarupyam. That vritti sarupyam he calls as vyutthana, as if getting up from samadhi. Samadhi is absorption in a particular point. Now, if the mind gets digressed, if the mind comes out of that state, Patanjali calls it vyutthana. And vyutthana siddhaya. When we are in our normal waking state, all these are powers. Siddhaya means powers. They are all powers in our normal waking state, but in our progress towards spirituality, they are obstructions. Our progress towards spirituality is going to happen through samadhi, and after we get full power of concentration by samadhi and knowledge, then we are going to have chitta nirodha. Chitta nirodha is not samadhi, it is the thing we will achieve after gaining samadhi. But we are not able to get samadhi at all because all these powers are obstructions. So we now again understand 36 in the light of this, because now the sutra has come about powers being obstructions. So even 36 is an obstruction. We are getting a feeling of Purusha's separateness, that's all. And that is leading us to super sensuous perceptions, which is a trap in our life. In Vedanta language, you say trap of Maya. So, this is the trap of Maya. You come, take this power. You come, take that power. We read in the life of Buddha, also in the life of Jesus, that when they reach the almost culmination of their concentration or knowledge. In Buddha's life, we read Mara, the demon, came to him. And Mara told him, stop your meditation. I will give the kingdom of the whole world. And he said, go away. I don't want to succumb to you. Mara said, where are you going? Unknown. Buddha said, maybe known or unknown, I will know it. And every hope of mine lies there, not here. That is how Buddha's life describes this. Jesus' case, Satan came. And Satan took him on the top of a hill. This may be figurative also, but it may be real also. Because from the top of the hill, he showed all the world. And I will make you the king of the world. Don't proceed further. And then Jesus said, get behind me, Satan. I don't want to look at you. I am proceeding forward. So, samadhu vyutthane siddhaya samadhu upasarga. Now, because I mentioned Vedanta in between, Vedantic samadhi is different. Vedantic samadhi gives us full knowledge. In Patanjali, after samadhi, we have to chitta nirodha. But in Vedanta, samadhi means total absorption in God. And that has given us full knowledge. And knowledge once gained never goes. The state of the mind will change. As we have three states every day, waking, dream and deep sleep. Similarly, this samadhi is a state in which we got the knowledge. Now that state will go. Then that is called vyutthana. That means we shall again perceive the world, but our knowledge will never go. We will never take the world to be real afterwards. Never, never, never. We know it is only an appearance. I have given the example that day of desert. When Swami Kanda was walking in the desert, let us take it up on ourselves. Suppose we are walking through a desert and we see water everywhere. But when we feel thirsty and go to that spot, we don't see water. So first we see water and we are aware of water. Secondly, we see no water, we see sand and we are aware of sand. And it reflects back that all these days I was seeing only sand appearing as water. This is equivalent to samadhi. In example, then we get up and again we see water. So our perception is water, but our consciousness is not water. Once we have gained the consciousness that the world is unreal, that Brahman alone is real, and the Brahman appears as the world, that will never go. And so now in Vyutthana, we are aware of Brahman appearing as the whole world. Perception of a cow, perception of a man, perception of mother, father, but the consciousness is Brahman appearing as mother, father, Brahman appearing as a cow. So this is the difference between perception and our knowledge about it. So, because of the word Vyutthana, I compared with Vedanta here. Samadhi also, Vedanta is different, Patanjali is different. Patanjali Samadhi is a step after which we have to do vritti nirodha. In Vedanta, samadhi is total absorption in God. And after that, the knowledge full has come. Now, another vibhuti. Why this sutra came here? It will reflect on the sutras coming, going. But because in between, it appeared as if we have reached the goal, so this sutra came. It appeared as if we are knowing the Purusha, so this sutra came that he has not yet reached the Purusha. Now 39. Bandha karana shaithilyat prachara samvedanacha chittasya parasharira vesha. We know from stories. Shankaracharya, let me tell that story. Shankaracharya went to convince Mandana Mishra that the path of knowledge will take you to the goal, not karma which you are doing. Karma will take you to heaven, which will not be permanent, But if you know your real nature, it will be permanent. Now, who was the judge? Mandan Mishra's wife, Ubhay Bharati, was the judge. And Shankara could convince Mandan Mishra. But Ubhay Bharati said, wife is a part of husband. So unless you convince me, you have to answer to my questions. And if you know everything, you have to know all the Shastras. And she asked some questions from the Kama Shastra, from the Shastra on fulfillment of desires of lust. Now, Shankar was a sannyasi. So from that body, he could not have replied that. So he said, give me 1 year time, I will come back and debate with you. He found one king, died just at that moment. Then he told his disciples to protect his own body in a forest. And he left his body and entered the king's body. And through that king's body, in about 1 year, he knew all the Kama Shastra. And came back in his own body, and then came back to Ubhay Bharati and replied to her questions. That is the story. Well, we are not concerned with the story, but because Para Sharira Vesha, we know that story. Now, Patanjali says, you can do that. Anybody can do Para Sharira Vesha. How? Bandha Karana Shaitilya. What is the Bandha Karana? Ajnan. What is the Bandha Karana? Self getting bound to Prakriti. Shaithilyat. It has become loose by now. It has not gone, but it has become quite loose. Shaithilyat. Now, Prachara Samvedanacha. And the yogi has come to know how I come and go through the body. How I get next life through the body. So his travel becomes free, accessible. His travel becomes accessible, prachara samvedana, as he knows now the way to travel. Chittasya. So with his own mind, he enters another body. Para sharira avesha. Here let me tell you something funny. Some boy, a good yogi, he was meditating on Shiva for 20 years. As a result, he entered into Shiva. But he thought it is like Para Sharira Vesha. So I told him, no, my friend, it is not Para Sharira Vesha. You have not left your body. You have not gone to other body. You have gone to your own Swarupa. Shiva is your Ishta Devata. Shiva is your Swarupa, though you have taken Shiva as an object of meditation. But Shiva is approximately your Swarupa. I am using the approximately, we call it Ishta Devata. And so you have entered him. It is not Parasharira Vesh. So don't confuse that you have entered some other body. Don't make Shiva as an object. But you are entering your own Swarupa. So I mentioned this because of the wrong identification, wrong thinking that I am doing Para Sharira Vesh. Anyway, but we understood now Para Sharira Vesh. 40, now 40. Udana Jaya Jala Panka Kantaka Dishu Asanga Utkrantishcha. You know, our Prana Vayu or Prana Energy is divided into five types. Prana, we inhale. Apana, we inhale. Prana, we outhale. When we outhale, that is prana. When we inhale, it is apana. Then, vyana is the energy which pushes our blood to the extremities of the body and brings it back. That pump of the heart, that is, works on vyana. And samana is the energy which digests our food. We eat food, and digestion means food is converted into bone, marrow, skin, blood, and the too much gross part is thrown away. The subtle part goes to mind. So this digestion is done by the samana energy. Now there is one more form of energy, and that is udana. In everyday life, if we get hiccups, that is udana vayu. But the actual function of udana vayu is at the point of death. It is the udana vayu which takes our eye consciousness to other body. So, with the help of udana vayu, our seed of the mind, our sanskara, seed of the mind, by death nothing is solved. The seed of the mind, udana takes that with the eye consciousness. Sanskaras gather around eye consciousness. So, eye consciousness with seed of sanskaras, sanskaras as the seed, take the help of udana vayu for death or then from going to other body. This is udana function. Now here, if we conquer udana, udana jaya, that means by concentrating on the udana vayu, we have conquered it. It has become our servant. It will do what we want to do. Then what happens? Jala panka kantaka dishu asanga. We have seen some yogis performing miracles. One of the miracles is walking on water. One of the miracles is walking on thorns. One of the miracles is walking through fire. He says, this will come to you. If you conquer udana vayu, that means your gravity is lost. The meaning is that your gravity is lost. That is why you are not sinking in the water. Your gravity is lost. That is why the thorns are not pinching you. Your gravity is lost. That is why the fire is not touching you. So, fire, water, thorns and fire, adishu, some other things. Asanga, we become unattached with that. We become separated from that. And utkrantischa. Utkranti means going away from life. As per our will, we can go away from our life, in between. This happens by the udana jaya. Udana is going to take us to next life. If we conquer it, we can go now outside our life. But all this is nonsense from our goal point of view. What happens? If we show miracles, people may pay us money. And what will they do with that money? Now, 44. Bahir akalpita vruttir mahavideha tata prakasha varanakshayaha. Now, vritti, there is a vritti of the mind. It is outside our body. Akalpita.
Maharaj, 41-42 getla nahi ka? 41-42.
42.
41 and 42. I think we are not explained.
Oh, yes, I missed them. From 40, yes, thank you. Samana jaya prajvalanam. Because all the pancha pranas we are going to conquer one by one. Udana jaya was told, now samana jaya. Now samana is the thing which digests food. If we conquer samana, then prajvalanam. Prajvalanam is not burning actually, but blaze of light. Our body becomes surrounded with a blaze of light. Next, Shrotra Kashayo Sambandha Sanyama Divyam Shrotram. Now our ears are connected with Akasha. Sound travels through space. So, sound in Vedanta, Akasha is a devata under which our hearing works. But in Sankhya, ears are connected with Akasha. Now, their connection, if we can make a sanyama on the connection of the ear with space, divyam shrotram, then we have divine hearing, a superconscious hearing. That is 42. 43, kaya kashayo sambandha sanyamat lagutula samapatyascha akasha gamanam. Our body is connected with akasha. If we can make a sanyam on the connection of the body with akasha, how body is connected? We live in akasha, so body is connected with akasha. But the exact connection we are able to perceive now, and if you make a sanyam on the connection of the body with akasha, sambandha sanyamat, then we will become so light, like cotton. Lagu means light, tula means cotton, samapatte, we become like that. Samapatti is similarity, like that. And another thing comes, akasha gamanam, we can fly through the sky. You see, the olden people did everything by their mental powers. And now we are achieving the same thing through the external science. And Swami Vivekananda has told us, the more man goes by the external science, he is losing the property of his mind. Previously we hear in Mahabharata, Ramayana war, Parjanyastra, Agnyastra, just by the power of mind and some mantra, the band, the arrow would become Agni, arrow would become so many things. Now we are looking for atom bombs, hydrogen bombs. So the inner power has gone. So here we can go through akasha. In Ramayana, Hanuman jumped is one thing. But all the Rakshasas had these powers. They were great tapasvis for achieving selfishness. And so we hear Vibhishana was kicked out by Ravana. So he, through akasha, came to where Rama was. Anyway, I'm not going to tell that story, but this is the akasha gamanam. So if you concentrate on the connection of body with the space, we will become as light as cotton and we can go through akasha. That was 43, and then 44. Now, today, please don't mind if I extend my time because we lost some time. Now, real modifications of the mind, what is real modification? By our wrong knowledge, we think that mind works within the body. But mind can work outside also. And they are real compared to our working in the mind, which is limited. If we work outside mentally, some people have tremendous mental power. Huh? They can go anyway. So, that is called Vruttir Mahavideha. Mental wave which is more than, which is, Videha means outside the body, Maha means greater, which is outside. That leads to prakasha avarana kshaya, covering of light of knowledge, you may say, avarana kshaya, it gets reduced. The covering of light of knowledge or light becomes reduced if we can meditate on it, if our mind can be taken outside the body and concentrate somewhere outside the body. That will be a Mahavideya Vritti. Not on a particular object like the Dharana Dhyan Samadhi, huh? But somewhere in space you concentrate. And we can, the light obstruction will be reduced. These are all powers, as again I told you, even if you do not understand them fully, it doesn't matter. स्थूल स्वरूप सूक्ष्म अन्वयार्थवत्व संयमात भूत जया। नाउ मैटर इज ग्रॉस एंड सटल। स्थूल स्वरूप, स्वरूप इज नेवर रियल नेचर इन पतंजलि, स्वरूप इज ऑलवेज द फॉर्म। सो ग्रॉस फॉर्म ऑफ द एलिमेंट्स, सूक्ष्म अन्वयार्थ एंड द सटलर इज द inside meaning sanyamat. So the gross form of the matter and the subtle form of the matter, if we can make a sanyam on this change, bhutajaya, we conquer, we come the mastery of the elements. Now what we'll do with the mastery of the elements? Some examples let us see. When Swami Vivekananda was in the south, he heard of a yogi, and he with his friends went to that yogi. And that yogi, they removed all his clothes and gave him a blanket so that he should not hide anything. And then from within that blanket, he produced before them so many things for eating and all that, fruits. And finally, roses with fresh dew drops, as if from nowhere. But yogis can produce as if from nowhere some things, because they have got mastery of the elements. So they combine the elements and produce out before you. So Swamiji has seen this. So sthula sarupa sukshma anvayartha vatva. Vatva means having that. Sthula having form, the sukshma having inside meaning. If we can make a sanyam on that, we conquer the matter. Then, tato animadi pradurbhava kaya sampat tad dharman abhigatascha. From this conquering the elements, what comes further? Animadi pradurbhava. Animadi means, you know, there are eight powers, special powers. Becoming small, becoming big, becoming light, becoming heavy, controlling others' minds. I don't want to recount. There are eight powers. Hanuman ji had all those powers. Now, so you know some story, going through on the ocean, somebody raised his mouth. He entered with a very small form and came out, and then became big and went forward. So like that, one thing, animadi pradurbhava, kaya sampat, the body becomes very nice, you may say beautiful or nice, sampatti, that means the property of the body shines, tad dharma anuvigatascha, and the bodily qualities will be unobstructed. In Ramayana we see, when Sita went to the forest, Atri, his wife, Anasuya, because of her purity of mind, she had all these powers without any yoga. And she said, Sita, I will give you something, something like ointment or something. And if you use that, you will always remain beautiful. Some such stories are there. So in the olden days, people had very easily these powers, and they never used it for wrong purpose. The right people, asuras used them all for wrong purpose. So this is tad dharma anubhigatascha. The quality of the body which you have gained will remain unobstructed. I'm tired of these powers. Now, what is the property of the body that is described in the 47? Rupa lavanya bala vajra samvandana twani kaya sampat. Rupa is beauty. Lavanya is another name for beauty of a different type. You describe in your own way, I will say delicateness, or when the beauty overflows, it is called lavanya. Bala, power. Vajra samvandana twani. Vajra means thunderbolt. Your body becomes as strong as the thunderbolt. Kaya Sampad, these are called special qualities of the body. Beauty, beauty overflowing, power, indestructibility like the thunder. Grahana Swarupa, Asmita Anvayartha Vatval, Sanyamad, Indriya Jayaha. Now what do our organs do? Grahana Swarupa. That means their nature is of taking in the objects. Asmita Anvayartha. And they work under eye consciousness. Indriyas take in objects, but they are working under eye consciousness. Sanyamat. So if you concentrate on this aspect of the organs, their capacity to catch objects, they are working under eye consciousness, Indriya Jaya. We conquer our Indriyas. Our Indriyas will not disturb us. That is the meaning of conquer. Tato Manojavitvam, Vikarna Bhava, Pradhana Jayascha. Now these are little leading us towards the goal. Huh? We have conquered the Indriyas. Tato, from that comes Manojavitvam. We will become as fast as mind. That is how Hanuman is described, of course. Manojavam, as fast as our mind will become. Vikarana Bhava. That means organs independently of the body can work. Organs independently of the body can work. We require our body for the organs to work. But the organs can work without a body. Pradhana Jayascha. Pradhana is the name given by Sankhya to what we call Prakriti. Why this name, you know? A king is there. He does not do everything. His pradhana means prime minister. Prime minister does everything. The king may be a titular head. So, Prakriti doing everything, it is called pradhana. Now, we conquer Prakriti. Instead of telling, he says, we conquer pradhana. I thought I will go beyond, but I stop here. Huh? Getting tired of this vibhutis. But now the last 3-4 vibhutis were somewhat useful. Let us see. And we will continue on the next day, Friday. Om Yogena Chittasya Padena Vacha Malam sharirasya cha vaidyakena yopakarottam pravaram muninam patanjalim pranjaliranatosmi. Om shanti shanti shanti. Harihi om tat sat. Shri Ramakrishna arpanamastu.